Hey guys, welcome back to this tutorial on current transformers, also known as instrument transformers. This is tutorial number 4. In this tutorial, it is required to specify a CT suitable for a dependent time over current relay. It's get interesting. Rated at 1 amp, having a resistive impedance of 0.25 ohm and connecting wiring of 0.5 ohm loop resistance. Please guys, pay attention to the problem statement because that will tell you where the story is going. And it says the maximum fault current that is referred to the secondary side of the CT is 25 times relay rating. Determine a suitable CT specification for this application that we just discussed, assuming a CT rated secondary current of 1 amp, okay? So that's a rated secondary current, 1 amp, which is exactly the same as stated here, an overcurrent relay rated at 1 amp. Now, what is an overcurrent relay? Now, as we can see here, the overcurrent relay that is rated at 1 amp is the relay that is connected at the secondary of the CT. And this is our current transformer that we need to specify. Now, we're not going to specify the relay. The relay is already there. But we need to choose and specify a current transformer that will work with the relay here. Now, that current transformer is due to operate in a protection discrimination as shown here. The overcurrent relay here connected at the primary is rated at 1 amp. So this means when a high current will pass through this bus bar, through the circuit breaker and through the primary of the current transformer, that high current will be proportional to the 1 amp at a secondary of the CT, and that is in accordance with the CT ratio. Now the 1 amp of current will then energize the coil of our overcurrent relay here, and that coil will trip the trip contact. That will then complete the circuit like this for this DC power supply. And that current will flow into this coil here, and that coil will then what? Be energized. And as a result, it will then pull another trip contact here, therefore releasing the circuit breaker and isolating the part of the circuit that is in trouble. And hopefully that will isolate the fault in time to save our equipment and of course the personnel that may have been exposed to the fault. So that is the CT, the current transformer that we need to choose so that it can operate in these discrimination configurations. Now before we can continue, please subscribe to CMTEQ channel and don't forget to like this tutorial and share to your social network. Thank you so very much for your support. Much appreciated. Now moving forward, they say assume a single phase application referred to IEC 185 specification. Now what we just described, that circuit is a single phase application, which basically if it's a three phase application, every phase could be dealt with individually. Okay, so now what's the next step to do is we need to solve this circuit according to the 185 specification. But what does the 185 specifications entails? It says that we have standard values of a rated secondary current, that is either 1 amp, 2 amps or 5 amps, nothing in between. That's how manufacturers design these current transformers. And we also have the standard values of the rated output. That's basically the burden, the city burden in volt ampere. That is ranging from 2.5 up to 30 volt ampere. And we also have the accuracy limit factors for protective cities. Now, that is between 5 to 30. Now, what is the accuracy limit factor? Now, the accuracy limit factors is the number that determines the magnitude of the current that can flow through the primary of the city, as we have seen. Now, for these selected standard values of 5 up to 30, let's say we have 1000 amps that's flowing on the primary. So if we take the accuracy limit factor of 15 or 10, that means it will be 1000 times 10. That's how much current can flow through the primary of that city before it reach saturation. Now, what happened when the current transformer reached saturation? Well, that means it's become useless. Because if it reaches saturation, it will never going to tell you how much current is flowing in there. It could be 100,000 amps of current. It will never going to have a proportional current to its secondary. That's why it becomes useless. And hopefully before it reaches saturation, your circuit breaker have already tripped and isolated the fault. Okay? And the next standard we have here is the accuracy class. Now we got two of them. That is 5P and 10P. This means these are the error, margins of error, that's going to be limiting this ones here. So if you say 1000 times 10, but that's going to be within, if it's a 5P, it's going to be within plus or minus 5%. If it's a 10P, it's going to be within plus or minus 10% of your CT. So that's basically what these standard values mean. So while working on the specific to select your current transformer, you have to be mindful of this because your city must be representative of the IEC 185 specifics. Okay, so now let's move on. At the end of this tutorial, if you stick around, we're going to select a current transformer that's going to look something like this. 15 VA 5P 10. That basically means 15 VA is the rated burden, 5P is the protection class, and 10 is the number of times that will multiply the rated current before it reach saturation. So this is a standard representation of a current transformer. Now in this tutorial, we're going to go through this calculation so that at the end of the day, we have a current transformer that can be selected. So stick around. This is very important, dear electrical engineering student. Okay, now we move on. Our solution. What's the first step? The first step is to calculate the total burden impedance. But how do we calculate the total burden impedance? What do we know? The problem statement is here. We can read it again, but it will be very helpful if we can illustrate it by drawing the schematic. This is our schematic. So we have a current transformer that is connected on a bus bar. There is a primary current that's going to be passing here, IP. IP is very big. And we have a relay that is attached at the secondary of the CT. We know that this is our overcurrent relay rated at 1 amp. And the relay have an internal resistance, okay, of 0 to 5 ohm. And we have connecting wires with a resistance of 0.5 ohm. So which means the first thing to do here is to calculate the total resistance in this setup. Because remember, our secondary current will be flowing through this circuit. So we need to know what's the total impedance that will influence that current. So let's go. Now the total impedance, that is total burden impedance, that will be the Z of the relay plus the Z loop, which is 0.5. And replacing the value, we found Z total to be as simple as 0.75 ohm. Are you with me, guys? Okay, so what's the next step? The next step is to find the useful voltage. Now, what is the useful voltage? This is where it gets interesting. Now, the useful voltage is the voltage that will drop across this resistance. Okay? Basically, across the total resistance in case of a short circuit. So, we must not confuse the useful voltage with a normal voltage drop that will drop across the city in a normal operation. Basically, 1 amp of current flowing. But the useful voltage is a voltage that drops across the impedance in case of a short circuit. But what did the problem statement tell us here? Let's go back there. It says here, maximum fault current referred to the secondary side of the city is 25 times relay rating. What is a relay rating? The relay is rated at 1 amp. Here it is. So which means we need to determine the useful voltage by first finding that maximum fault current. So our formula for the useful voltage is a Z total times the I secondary in short circuit. Basically, not the normal I secondary, but the short circuit I secondary. That is then equal to 25 times the I relay. And that is equal to 25 amps because the relay current is 1 amp. Now, since we now determined the 25 amps, which is the short circuit current in our case here, we can then go ahead and determine the useful voltage by simply multiplying the total impedance times 25, and we have 18.7 volt, which is the useful voltage, not the useless voltage, but the useful voltage. You'll know why it is useful, not useless. Okay, we move on. Third step. Step number three, the rated burden. Now, we've already calculated the rated burden in many of our previous tutorial. We know that the rated burden is simply the VA, okay, that is dropped across this circuit here based on the 1 amp current that is flowing. So that is given by the formula SB is ZB times IN squared. It's basically the power formula. And that gives us, since our Z total is 0.75 and the current is 1 amp at normal nominal current, so we find 0.75 VA. Okay? Step number four, we need to select the rated burden SB from the given data. Now, it says here standard value of rated secondary current are 1 amp, 2 amp. No. It says here standard value of rated output are as follow: 2.5, 5, 10, 15, and 30 VA. Okay, but we've calculated a value that is not even 1, it's 0.75. So we need to select from this data. So what's the closest value, since we cannot go lower? The closest value for us here is 2.5. Remember, if we found the value that was like 3, we wouldn't have gone to 2.5, we'll go to 5. So we must always get a value that is slightly higher, basically higher than the calculated. So we found 2.5 VA. That's a selected city rated value. Step number five. Step number five, the corresponding voltage. Now, the corresponding voltage is basically the voltage that corresponds to the city rated VA. And this is given by the formula SB divided by the I secondary of the city, which is a 1 amp nominal. And we find a value of 2.5 volt. Moving on, step number six, the accuracy limit factor. Now, we've already discussed this accuracy limit factor, what it means earlier. Now, the accuracy limit factor is basically given by the following formula. That is ALF equal to useful volt divided by the corresponding voltage. Now, you know why we calculated the useful voltage. Now, you can see why it's useful, because it is now used to calculate the ALF, which is these values here that basically determine how much the magnitude of current that it can be allowed to pass through the city primary before it reaches saturation. So we find the accuracy limit factor of 7.5, but we can see that it's not a standard value. So what do we do then? We need to select a value that is higher, not lower than the calculated. So based on that, we will then select an accuracy limit factor of 10. Okay, that is this one. Okay guys, we are almost done with our calculations here. We are almost done with the specification of our city. So what is the final and last steps? The final step here is step number 8. We need to write our answer as a selected city. Now the answer must be given by the accuracy current limit. Now the accuracy current limit, or ALC, is given by ALF times IN times P. P is given by the protection. That signifies it's a protective city. ALF is obviously the accuracy limit factor, and IN is the nominal current of the secondary. And replacing the values here, we have 10 times 1 times P, and as you can see, it gives us 10P. Now, this 10P here means our city, so we only have two classes of protection. There's a 5P and 10P. So our city must be a 10P, which means we're going to have a plus or minus 10%. Okay? Plus minus 10% error will be allowed from the value of the magnitude of the current that will cross on the primary of the city before it reaches saturation. Okay? From there then, our final answer is then going to be 2.5 VA 10P10. So this is our selected city. So the city is rated at 2.5 VA, and it's got a plus minus 10% accuracy error, and the allowable current that must flow through the primary before it reaches saturation is 10 times the rated primary current. Okay guys, please, thank you very much for watching this tutorial. If you have learned something, don't forget to give it a thumbs up and subscribe to CMTEQ channel. And please come back for more tutorial like this to enforce your electrical engineering knowledge. Thank you guys for watching. Cheers.